Well, I think there was a lot of communication also between biologists in the early 1960s, and not as much picking up the telephone and calling somebody, and certainly no internet or email, but there was many, many opportunities to come together at meetings for face-to-face encounters between scientists. But where the real power is now is this tremendous access that you have to the world's literature. Quite literally, you're able to immediately scan the contents of most journals the moment they're put on the internet. You are able to contact websites that are dedicated to specific biological problems. And your ability to go through the world's literature and really have complete access to it makes a tremendous difference.
Does that mean that scientists today are less proprietary and more willing to share their work with others?
Oh, I don't. I think that scientists are, at that time, were very willing to share the information they had gained, but of course desired some attribution or credit for that work, because after all, what you work for in this business is perhaps as the most valuable reward is the grudging appreciation of a few colleagues who really understand what you're doing. And once you're satisfied, which probably no one ever is, that you've got that, then you're quite willing to share, anxious to share, enthusiastic about sharing the results of your work. That's really what you live for.